Let's explore a fossil museum to discover fossil bones. Stay until the end to help us solve three dinosaur puzzles. Let's go! Hello Carbs, it's me, Mr. Albie. Let's visit this fossil museum and act like real paleontologists and dinosaur scientists. Dinosaur scientists dig up dino bones and other animal remains from a long time ago. But dinosaur bones come in many different pieces, and so it's a dinosaur scientist's job to put all of those puzzle pieces together, just like this puzzle right here. Discovering fossils is like turning back time so that we can learn more about ancient animals from long, long ago. We can learn about what they ate, how they looked like, and how the world was before people were around. We'll explore the fossil museum as we play dinosaur puzzle games. Come on! Finding fossils helps us to map out all of the dinosaurs so that we can know more about the type of dinosaur, what dinosaur family they're from, and what era, the time that that dinosaur comes from. Let's look at real dinosaur fossils.
Yeah.
Check out the claws on these dinosaur fossils. First here, we have an Edmontosaurus. Edmontosaurus was like a duck-billed dinosaur. And look, you can see it has three toes.
Wow.
Over here, we've got a Sinraptor. And here, it's got really long claws. Third one is a Utahraptor. What's special about their toes is that one of them has a long claw like this. Wowza! And finally, here we've got a Tarbosaurus claw. And we've got the middle toe of its claw, which is really long. Wow. Cubs, why don't you show me your claws? Yeah! Rawr! Check out this dinosaur outline right here behind me. It's like a dinosaur puzzle, but it's got a lot of missing pieces. It's only got one up there. Do you know what dinosaur this is?
Pachycephalosaurus.
This is actually a Pachycephalosaurus. Say it with me. Pachycephalosaurus. Yeah, we know this because of its fossil skull. And on its head, you can see a hard, hard skull.
Ooh, fossils.
Cubs, I'm just so excited. This is the first time I've ever seen anything like it. This is a dinosaur head, yeah. It's the skull of a dino. Do you know what dinosaur this is? Oh, maybe you don't, but you can see it's got eyes, it's got nose, and it's got some horns over here, and an armored head. But you know what type of dino this is by looking back there at its tail. Come with me. You can see the dino outline. But there's a lot of missing fossil pieces, but right here, we know what dino it is because of this hammer-like tail. What dino is it?
Ankylosaurus.
It's an Ankylosaurus! Wowza! This tail's amazing! Ah! Look at the dinosaur fossil bones here, cubs! Do you know what dinosaur this is?
T-Rex.
Yes, it's a Tyrannosaurus Rex. Now, let's practice saying that word. Tyrannosaurus Rex. Roar! Now, dinosaur names can be really long, so it helps to break down the different sounds of those dino names. So it's also like a puzzle, isn't it? Now, what dinosaur parts do you see of this T-Rex? You can see its head, and it's also got big teeth there. Ah! And you can also see its claws right there. Yeah! Dinosaurs can also leave footprint fossils behind so that we can know how big their feet were. Whoa! Check out this Tyrannosaur footprint right here. And let's compare my shoe size with their foot size. Wowza! Tyrannosaurus really had a big foot, huh? They would need big shoes, right? Ah. Just like a dino puzzle game, paleontologists can put all the different dinosaur puzzle pieces together to get a picture of how a real dinosaur skeleton looked like. Let's play a dinosaur puzzle game and be like real dinosaur scientists putting the pieces together. When you have a dino puzzle, it helps to start with the ends. So let's start off with this puzzle piece. Oh, what's this?
Head.
Yes, it's the head and the neck. We put it here on the end, right there, right. Now we'll do the other end, which is called the
tail.
The tail, yeah. Put it right there. Also helps to put some of the end pieces over here. And this is a
leg.
A leg, right. This is a leg, and this dino. Oh, this goes right there. Now we've got another
leg.
Leg, yeah. Connect that right here to the neck. Then we've got the rest of its
body.
So connect it right here. Oh, that's not right. There you go. And now you can see here a long neck dinosaur with a long tail, long neck, smaller head, big body. Do you know what dinosaur this is, Cubs?
Brachiosaurus.
This is a Brachiosaurus. Say it with me. Brachiosaurus. Right. Now, Brachiosaurus had a really long neck so that it could reach up and eat leaves from high, tall trees. And I bet you're wondering, which was bigger, a Tyrannosaurus Rex or a Brachiosaurus? Well, actually, Tyrannosaurus Rex was one of the biggest theropods, or two-legged dinosaurs. Brachiosaurus was one of the biggest four-legged dinosaurs, and Brachiosaurus was definitely bigger than a T-Rex. What's so interesting about this fossil museum is that scientists discovered real fossils just near here, and those fossils were from the Ice Age, when much of the world was covered with ice and snow. Now let's discover this other ancient animal that ate plants and was really big. Do you know what animal this is? This is a mammoth. And mammoths were herbivores, meaning they ate plants, especially eating grass. And they were like really big elephants with long tusks. Right. Check out these fossil bones of the mammoth. Scientists then use fossil bones to know how a real mammoth looked like. They were a lot woolier than elephants today, and they're a lot bigger. The big woolly mammoth also had big feet. Let's see a mammoth's footprint and compare our foot to their foot. Come on, check out these footprints of a real mammoth. Whoa, you had big feet. Mammoths were so big that scientists believe they weighed as much as 3 trucks. Wowza! Cubs, do you know what animal this is? It looks like a rhino, but actually it's an ancient animal, part of the rhino family. It lived a long time ago in the Ice Age. And what's special about this animal is its really long horn. Yeah, right there. Whoa, it's so long. Take a look at this ancient Hayasaka rhino. It's a really big rhino that existed a long time ago. When you put all the pieces of the fossil bones together, it looks something like this. Now let's be like paleontologists and put together our own fossil puzzle. First, we need to take out all the fossil pieces. Then, we can start putting the fossil pieces together. Terrific! Now, we've joined the pieces together of this dinosaur. Cubs, do you know what dinosaur this is?
Parasaurolophus.
It's a Parasaurolophus. Say it with me. Parasaurolophus. Parasaurolophus. Yeah. Now, there are three things that a Parasaurolophus has in common with an ancient rhino. The first thing is that Parasaurolophuses and rhinos, like this ancient one, they don't exist anymore. You can't see them. You can only learn about them through their fossils. Number two, they're both herbivores. They eat plants. And number three, they have special heads. Parasaurolophus is special because it has this thing on its head. This is a crest on the back of its head, right there. That's how we know it's a Parasaurolophus. Parasaurolophus used its crest actually to make a trumpeting sound, like this. But instead of out front like here, the trumpet's like at the back of its head. Now a rhino, an ancient one, is also special with its head because it has a horn at the front of it. Check out this fossil lab. This is where scientists examine the fossils that they found. They clean them up and they try to name them and try and put the fossils together so that they can know what they've discovered. But where can we find fossils? Let's find out. As we go down, take a look at all the different kinds of rocks that you can find dinosaur bones and other fossils. Those are found in many places, but most fossils can be found in large rocks or open pits and deep holes in the ground. Check out this fossil and how the scientists dug it up. Some people have even found fossils at the beach. You can check the coastline and sometimes fossils wash up on shore. Ooh. Look at these really, really old shell fossils. And they're called cephalopods. Amazing. Take a look at these really, really old sea fossils. They're called trilobites. Look at this fossil that looks like an ice cream cone. This is a conidae, or cone snail. Some people have even found fossils in their garden, so you can find some fossils in your backyard too. These here are amber fossils. Don't they look like jewels? Now, amber fossils happen when plants secrete out resin, and animals get trapped in that resin. And they become these beautiful amber fossils. Watch out, there's a big insect fossil. Oh, it's a meganeura. Some people even find fossils at construction sites. Cubs, remember that time we had a learning adventure about excavators and we discovered a dino egg? Yeah, let's open it up and find out what's inside. 3, 2, 1. Wowza! Oh, there's all these pieces. It's a dinosaur puzzle. Let's put those pieces together and find out what dinosaur it is. This body, ooh, this dinosaur has two small arms. We'll connect its neck right there, yeah. Oh, look at this small piece here. That looks like a tongue. Connect that tongue to the upper part of this upper head of this dinosaur. Yeah. Oh. Now we'll connect the bottom part of its head. Right there. Ooh. One leg, two legs. Ooh, it's got two big legs. Now it's got top part of its tail. We'll connect here to its body. Then one more piece, and it's the tip of its tail right there. Do you know what dinosaur this is?
T-Rex.
It's a Tyrannosaurus Rex. Yeah, carbonific. Now here's a fun fact about T-Rexes. Did you know that a T-Rex has teeth as long as a banana? Imagine if you had teeth as long as a banana. Ah, how silly. That was fascinating, learning about fossils and playing dinosaur puzzles with you at the Fossil Museum. When you play with puzzles, it's just like real paleontologists putting together the pieces of fossil bones. Until next time, cubs away!